Okay, so how do we call an event in Udon? Well, if it's a custom event in our own script, we can simply right-click, go Create Node, the shortcut for this is spacebar, then we want to go Udon Behavior, Send Custom Event. Now, all we have to do is hit this little drop-down menu and select our custom event's name. Awesome! So what if we wanted to call it on another script? Well, over here I have another Udon script, and on it I have another custom event called the Other Custom Event. Coming back to our original script, the first thing the node needs is to know what Udon behavior the event is on. To do so, we're going to go to our variables tab, we're going to hit this little plus button, and then we're going to go Udon behavior. I'm going to call this Udon behavior the other script, and I'm going to hit this little drop down menu and hit public. This will allow us to select what Udon behavior it is inside the inspector. And now that we have the Udon behavior, we're going to drag that into the graph, and we're going to plug that into the instance part of the send custom event. Now, you'll also notice that you can't use the drop down menu for an event on another script. This is because the script has no way of knowing what events are on the other script, so therefore we need to specify what the name of this other event is called. To do so, we simply want to go create node, string, construct string. And now I'm just going to pop over to my other script, I'm going to copy its event name, because it is case sensitive, and then I'm going to come back to my own script and paste it into the string slot. And now all that's left is to plug the string into the event name, and we've successfully called an event on another script. Awesome, but now what if you wanted to send a delayed event? Well, by going get node Udon behavior, when we type in send custom event, we see two delayed event options. We can go custom event delay by frames or custom event delayed by seconds. As the name would suggest, custom event delayed by frames will delay it by a certain amount of frames. The amount of frames is specified by an int value. And custom event delayed by seconds will delay it by a certain amount of seconds done as a float value. More often than not, you'll find delayed by seconds a lot more useful than delayed by frames. Now, on both these nodes, we also have another input called event timing. This is the same as the event nodes update and late update, with late update happening after all the things in update have been done. More often than not, in default Unity, you'd leave late update for things like camera movement. For example, say if you had an object that you were following, you would want the camera's position to update after the object has moved for that frame. But for most of the time, you can just ignore this setting. Awesome, so now we know how to do a delayed event in Udon, but what if we wanted to do a networked event instead? As currently, all of this is happening only for the local player and isn't happening globally. Well, when we go get node Udon behavior send custom event, we'll see the last one is send custom networked event. And when this node is played, it will tell whoever specified to play a custom networked event. We can specify who plays this event by this target input. When we hit this little drop-down menu, we can see two options. We have either all or owner. The owner is the person who manages all the synced variables for this object in this world instance. Now, let's say when you hit the button you want everyone to see some fireworks shoot out, we want to hit all so that everyone will play the same event. However, let's say you want to change a variable in the script but you didn't want to change the owner of the object, you can simply send an event to tell it to flip a ball or something. In that case, you would only want to send it to the owner as no one else is able to change those synced variables. Awesome, so that's how you send a networked event. However, what if you wanted to send a custom networked event but you wanted a delay on it? Well, an ultimately slightly hacky easy way of doing this would be to create a custom event that its sole purpose is to send a custom networked event. So if I was to add a random custom networked event, and I was to call that from my delayed event, I could then get that event to send a custom networked event. So, hopefully that was helpful for you. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you got any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!